Hello. Praise be to Jesus Christ. I am Bishop James Thopil from the Diocese of Kohima in the state of Nagaland. The Mission Diocese of Kohima covers the entire state of Nagaland. Nagaland is one of the smallest states in the extreme northeastern part of India, bordering Myanmar, or we call Burma. Nagaland is inhabited by people of Mongoloid race who are divided into various tribes, but they are collectively known as Nagas. In Nagaland, there are 16 major tribes, each tribe has its own distinct customs, traditions, and languages. Nagas were known for their qualities of hospitality, honesty, equality, and sharing, although some of these values have disappeared. They are also people of great valor and courage, and even today there are active movements for independence from India. Nagaland is one of the three states in India that has got majority Christians. As early as 1847, the Baptist missionaries came to Nagaland and most Nagas became Christians, unfortunately not Catholics. Majority of them belong to the American Baptist denominations. The Catholic Church came to Nagaland very late, and that too, one may say, by chance. You know, one of the decisive battles of the Second World War was fought in Kohima, called the Battle of Kohima. I'm sure some of you might have seen the movie called Bridge on the River Kwai. The Japanese crossed over Myanmar or Burma and reached Kohima and attacked the Allied military camp there. It is said that more than 3,000 Allied soldiers were killed in that battle. But the Allied forces, with the help of the local people, defeated the Japanese, and thus began the Allied forces' drive against the Japanese in the east. Today in the Kohima, there is a beautiful war cemetery maintained by the Commonwealth. At the entrance of this cemetery, there is a beautiful epitaph that goes like this: "When you go home, tell of us that for your tomorrow we gave our today." Now, as a reward for helping the British rule the war, the British government built a hospital for the local people called Naga Hospital, which is the biggest hospital in Nagaland even today. In 1948, there was no one who could run or administer such a hospital. So the governor of Assam requested the Archbishop Stephen Ferrando, a Salesian bishop from Italy, whether he could find some religious sisters or brothers to run the hospital. Finally, he found two sisters from the Society of the Sisters of Christ Jesus from Spain, who, along with Monsignor Bars, another Salesian from Italy, came to Kohima in 1949, December. In fact, one of the two sisters, Sister Guadalupe, died this year only, on the 17th of March, at the age of 97. They were strictly forbidden to teach or preach about Catholic faith. The sisters write in their memoirs that whenever they got a chance to go into villages, they used to bury secretly crosses and medals, praying and hoping that the Catholic Church grew in Nagaland. The sisters left 1952 Kohima after 3 years of their contract, since they were not free to exercise their missionary mandate. But by then they had catechized and baptized about three people in the hospital. At the same time, a few elders from another village, another tribe, the Lotha tribe, who had a disagreement with the Baptist Church, went down to Golaghat in Assam and got instructed in Catholic faith. And this is how the Catholic Church began in Nagaland, the first baptism being 1952, December. Today there are over 62,000 Catholics in the whole diocese, and evangelization is very active and alive. Another good news is that today we have lots of vocation to priesthood and religious life from among the Naga tribes. Already we have 57 priests and over 200 sisters. More and more people from the different villages joined the Catholic Church despite many difficulties and oppositions. Some of them have to leave the village because they want to become Catholics. When a group of five or more families join the Catholic Church, we request them to build their own church. They build their church using the local materials like bamboos and leaves available in the village, which does not last long. They have to repair and renovate the church every year. After a few years, when we see that the people are well instructed in Catholic faith and are strong and convinced, the diocese tries to help them to build a good or a better church, if possible a church built with the bricks and cement. A good church is a matter of pride and necessity for them, especially in the context of vast majority of Baptists who look down upon this small community disparagingly. A good church gives them an identity, and they use it like a multi-purpose hall. Besides celebrating the Holy Eucharist, whenever the priest visits the village, the church is also used by various groups, women, youth, Holy Childhood Association, Legion of Mary, etc., for their weekly prayer meeting and gatherings. Presently, there are about 256 villages with Catholic communities. Many of these communities do not have a good church. Therefore, the purpose of my mission appeal is to build a village church. It's a small church of about 60 into 30 square feet or 600 square meters with a small portico. The cost of the church is about $32,000, and it costs $20 for building up 1 square feet of the built up area. In fact, with the last year's mission appeal from the Diocese of St. Petersburg and Palm Beach in Florida, we built a small church for the community in Moyland. I hope to complete this project within a year. Therefore, I appeal and thank you in anticipation for your great generosity. Thank you and God bless you.